because like when you look at the traditions, like in New Zealand, for instance, of the traditional tattoos of the indigenous people there, they raised that to a very high art form. And I think you're right about that. There's something moving through the world. I mean, there's this thing in the 60s, there was this whole kind of body awareness movement, and this sort of for this time is somehow really deeply connected into some sort of body awareness movement. Mm-hmm. It's really intriguing.
Well, you mentioned this, I mean, it's been the last 20 years especially where tattooing has become bigger and bigger and bigger. Right. And I've been around tattoo artists 10, 15 years ago when it was surging, and they're going, oh, it's going to topple off really soon, and it's like,
right.
Oh, it's getting bigger. And there's no way that is just a fad.
No, it's not a fad.
There's some undertow, some kind of intelligence node or whatever that's surfacing, and then the outside of it has that kind of more superficial dynamic, almost like a sloughing off some kind of dead skin.
Right.
But I feel like there's an intelligence coming through, and it's coming clearer and clearer through the people getting them, through the people doing them.
That makes a lot of sense. I mean, it's like I've felt the impact of it, but I haven't really thought very deeply about it in that way. But yeah, you're absolutely right. Mm-hmm. It's really interesting. I begin to look for every time that the Western culture begins to move from a more conservative frame to a more liberal, exploratory frame, and they begin to sort of break through habituated patterns that have been imposed, there's certain things that begin to happen that really mark part of that. Mm-hmm. And it always, an integral part of it is always sexuality, body dynamics, entheogen use, music shift.
Mm-hmm.
There's this whole thing that begins to happen. But every time it's different, it's usually every other generation, about every 50 years, you get that movement beginning to happen and taking on its own form. And, yeah, it's obvious the tattoo movement is deeply part of that this time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's I feel blessed just being a part of it and moving it forwards and bringing more awareness to it. I get a lot of clients, most of the time, are at a large pivotal stage in their life, and that somehow intuitively, and it must be intuitively, because how could someone who's just had a near death or death in the family or some not necessarily traumatic, but pivotal.
You know, a marker, experience. A change, a moment of change that's significant. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And quite a lot of the times they're not someone who gets tattoos, and yet they'll turn them up on my doorstep saying, I don't know what I'm doing here, but I'm just following this.
I just feel like I should get a tattoo. Yeah. And it needs to be sort of like this.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah, I have one good example is a woman, Anita, who died a couple of years ago. She'd been fighting cancer for 29 years. Our naturopath sent her to me. And she said, like, I've never gotten a tattoo. I never thought about getting it. She had a double mastectomy, and she didn't want to go and get plastic surgery. She wanted to define her beauty in her own way.
Right.
But she had been working on her own inner healing.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, she wasn't going to fight the inevitable
of
life ending, but
it
was this other level of healing, and she just intuitively ended up on my doorstep, said, this is what I need to do.
Mm-hmm.
She had her whole family that were crazy Christian extremists who were about ready to disown her, but it didn't stop her from coming forth and getting this work done. And everything that unfolded, even one day I did one side of her chest, the other day I did the other side. So two full days sitting or lying down, and most of the time, tears were just flowing down her face. She wasn't in anguish.
Right.
It was just she looked more like an angel. It was like this just release.
Ah, interesting. That's fascinating.
Down.
Yeah.
And she mentioned afterwards how little synchronicities, like the first side that I chose, it was up to me, was she had each breast removed at different times.
Mm.
And in between, breastfed her daughter, so on. And I just happened to have chosen this significant side that went first.
Mm-hmm.
These little things that I had no idea
right.
about
right.
that she had mentioned after. And she had mentioned to me, I just want to mention this dream, where she was inside of a human heart.
Mm-hmm.
And there were many other people in there that were kind of working. And this heart was just beating and pulsating. And she felt the sense, and it was, she felt it, that she would be crushed and they would be crushed if they didn't. Well, what ended up happening was she just intuitively went with something and tuned into the heart,
mm-hmm.
and went with the flow because she was tuned in and therefore wasn't getting crushed. But
mm-hmm.
beyond that, she got tuned into this, I don't know, I'll call it a network or an awareness through the heart.
Mm-hmm.
And this is all just stuff through getting the tattoo, and I think also being close to death
right.
brought awareness
right.
up as well. But
yeah, it's fascinating work.
Pretty neat stuff.
Yeah, it is.
That goes on. I just wanted to show you a couple of images here to give you just an idea of some of this is Anita here.
Oh, that's beautiful.
A lot of what I do in
tattoo
work is I try to, it's sort of the metaphysical background we talked about,
mm-hmm.
I think, for the wave in the ocean.
Right.
I try to get something not to be just separate,
right.
but I try to give that sense that nothing is separate and detached and everything's
mm-hmm.
part of some larger flow.
Yeah, that's beautiful.
Yeah, you know, that's quite a nice piece. And there's a woman, Anna, who's, when her son was 3 days away from coming in for a tattoo, he was 21 years old, she went in to wake him up and he was dead. And
wow.
No one knew what happened, it was just his time.
Wow.
And this is her tattoo that she got to process.
Wow.
For her, gardening is how she
uh-huh.
did her therapy on herself. And just
a good way to do therapy.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
So
oh, I see.